actually know your intention or Allah alone knows that, you know, really what is in your heart? Do we actually know it or Allah alone that can judge that?
You see, the purpose of this, you know, something interesting about Imam Ghazali, rahimahullah, he said this is meant to have a person to try to be in high level. As a human being, who struggle with that. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of course, forgive certain things come happen to us. Once in a while, we like, you know, two things. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive those kind of shortcoming. But if a person become a pattern of behavior is riya, and that's why he said, there's different categories of them. A person always does things to show off. That person does not have any good deeds. Rasulullah said, the first people that help fire to start with is a person that have a lot of knowledge. Then Allah asked him, what did you use the knowledge? Allah taught it to people. He said, no, you taught it to people because one people say you're alim, you're a scholar. And people have said that. You get the reward in dunya, and in akhir you have nothing. They drag him to hellfire. Person said, oh, I give money left and right. He said, you did that because you want to be elected. And you were elected to office. You got your praise in dunya. You were in the front page of Washington Post every week. You were this and that. That was your intention? Did you get that in dunya? We gave you what you asked for in dunya. You have nothing in akhirah. Then a person also died for the cause of Allah and so forth. The hadith talking about the four categories of people. If riya become a pattern of behavior or something that they do all the times, they're very dangerous. But this meant to have us to try to discipline ourselves and fight these ego things inside ourselves.
Yes, I think the greatest riya is the riya of the self.
Of discipling oneself.
Man is something that, you know, it's because, you know, when I look at myself and when I accept the Islam, I mean, there is so much in terms of struggles, you know, there's so many different level of struggles, you know, and it's based on your faith again.
MashaAllah, you struggle to surrender sometimes, to submit. Yes.
The struggling, it really makes you, it makes you very strong.
Absolutely. It's a good struggle.
One of the things that I always say, you know, let people say negative thing about Islam, but your character as a Muslim, you know, this is how I always look at things. Your character should be, you know, like I always tell my children, they cannot say anything that I lie or I promise them, you know, and this is very important for a Muslim. We should really strive to, you know, to be a good person. Let people say whatever they want about Islam, because this Islam belongs to Allah and to protect that. But we as Muslims, we should always try to do our best and be a good example.
Make your objective is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and everything comes along. The objective is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.